With streams and wind problems, you have to remember that when you go downstream, your rate is added to, or you get help that's positive. When you are going against the stream or upwind, you get negative help. Zoe rows a boat downstream for 80 miles. If he's going downstream and it says the current flows at 3 miles per hour, we add 3. His time is T and it takes him 80 miles. If he then returns, his rate will be against the stream, and it says it takes 12 hours longer, so T plus 12. Same distance. Now, we have to ask, how fast does he go in still water? That means we need to find rate, so we divide both by R plus 3 in the first equation to get T is equal to 80 over R plus 3. In the second equation, we again divide by the R binomial. This gives us T plus 12 is equal to 80 over R minus 3. We take the first, solve for T, and plug it into the second T, which gives us 80 over R plus 3 plus 12 equals 80 over R minus 3. Our LCD is equal to R plus 3 times R minus 3. Multiplying through, and dividing out the common factors, clear the denominators. From here, we're given foiling R plus 3, R minus 3 gives R squared minus 9 equals 80 times R plus 3. Distributing, gives us this. Subtracting 80R from both sides and subtracting 240, that was supposed to be a 240, not a 24, gives us negative 480 plus 12R squared minus 108 equals 0. Rearranging this and adding like terms gives us 12R squared minus 588 equal to 0. We can divide both terms by 12, which gives us R squared minus 49 equals to 0. Factor, and we get R plus 7, R minus 7. Setting my factors equal to 0 gives me R is equal to negative 7 or R is equal to positive 7. I can't have a negative rate, so this is my rate. In the second problem, we have Darius flies a plane against a headwind for 5,084 miles. So the rate has to be against a headwind. The wind speed is 10 miles per hour, so we have to subtract 10. The time, t, equals 5,084 miles. When he returns, it's r plus 10 times t, and it took 20 hours less, so minus 20 on the return trip, but goes the same distance. We want to know how fast, so we have to divide both by r minus 10 on the first one and r plus 10 on the second one. When we do this, we get two equations. T is equal to 5,084 divided by r minus 10. And the second one is t minus 20 equal to 5,084 divided by r plus 10. Substituting for t, we get 5,084 over r minus 10 minus 20 equals 5,084 over r plus 10. Our LCD is equal to r plus 10 times r minus 10, which would also be r squared minus 100. After distributing the LCD, we'll be left with 5,084 times r plus 10 minus 20 times r squared minus 100 equals 5,084 times r minus 10. Multiplying through, we get this. We can now subtract 5,084 r from both sides, and we get these add to zero, and we get 52,840 minus 20 r squared equals negative 50,840. If we add 50,840 to both sides, we get negative 20 r squared plus 103,680 equals zero. We can now divide by negative 20 on both of these terms, and we get r squared minus 5,184 equals zero. This is a perfect square, or actually a difference of squares, which is r plus 72 and r minus 72. So r plus 72 equals 0, when set equal to 0. So r is equal to negative 72, or r is equal to positive 72. It can't be negative, so this is my rate in still air.